Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the VD lecture in the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. This is lecture number 10.3. So the topic is Problem Solving in Dimensional Analysis. We recap from the earlier lecture. In the earlier two lectures, we discussed the theory part of the dimensional analysis, the need for dimensional analysis and methods of dimensional analysis. We discussed the Rayleigh method and the Buckingham Pi method. Also, we discussed the similitude and types of similitude, dimensionless parameter or non-dimensional numbers, application of dimensionless parameters and model analysis. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the dimensional analysis. Example number 1, the efficiency eta of a fan depends on the density rho, the dynamic viscosity mu of the fluid, the angular velocity omega, the diameter d of the rotor and the discharge q. Using Rayleigh method, show that efficiency eta equal to a function of mu divided by rho omega d square and q divided by omega d to the power 3. The solution to the problem, the efficiency of the fan depends on the density, dynamic viscosity, angular velocity, diameter and discharge. So we can write the functional relationship eta equal to a function of rho comma mu omega d and q. We can express in terms of eta equal to k is a constant, non-dimensional constant, into rho to the power a, mu to the power b, omega to the power c, capital D to the power D and Q to the power E. We take this is equation number 1. Now, the various parameter involved, dimensions of the various parameter involved in the problem. Efficiency eta is a non-dimensional parameter. So, M to the power 0, L to the power 0, T to the power 0. Density rho, dimensions is M, L to the power minus 3. Viscosity mu, M, L to the power minus 1, T to the power minus 1. Diameter D, L. Discharge Q, L to the power 3, T to the power minus 1, angular velocity omega, T to the power minus 1. Now, substituting the dimensions in the equation 1. So, we have the equation eta equal to K into rho to the power A, mu to the power B, omega to the power C, D to the power D and Q to the power E. Now, you substitute the dimensions left hand side, M to the power 0, L to the power 0, T to the power 0, K is a constant. Rho m l to the power minus 3 into the power a, mu m l to the power minus 1, t to the power minus 1 to the power b, omega t to the power minus 1 to the power c, d l to the power d, q l to the power 3, t to the power minus 1 to the power e. Now we have m l t term on the left hand side and m l t term on the right hand side. We equate the powers of m l t on both sides. So for m, we write left hand side always 0. So, 0 equal to the m term on the right side. So, a powers of m, m to the power a here, m to the power b here. So, a plus b equal to 0. For term l, so here l to the power minus 3, so minus 3a. Here l to the power minus 1b, so minus b. Here l to the power d, d. So, there is no other l terms. So, 0 equal to minus 3a minus b plus d plus 3e. And t to the power 0, t equal to 0 on the left hand side and on the right hand side, here we have minus b, then minus c and minus e. So, minus b, minus e and minus c. There are 5 unknown and 3 equations. So, a, b, c, d, e are the 5 unknowns and we have only 3 equations. It is not possible to find the value of the constant. So, the value of a, c, d are derived in terms of b and t. That means we represent a, c, d in terms of b and e. We take the m equation. For m, a plus b equal to 0, we write a equal to minus b. In the last term, we take c equal to minus b and e. So, c equal to minus b and e. And in the second equation, l equation, we find d. So, d equal to 3a plus b minus 3e. So, substitute a from here, b and c is not here. So, minus 3b. So, minus 3b plus b minus 3e equal to minus 2b minus 3e. So, a, c, d in terms of b and e. Now, substitute the value in the equation. So, eta equal to, we have k, constant k into rho to the power a, mu to the power b, omega to the power c, d to the power d, and q to the power e. So, a, the value of a is minus b. So, rho to the power minus b, b, there is no change, mu to the power b, c is minus b minus e, so mu to the power minus b minus e, and d to the power d, which is minus 2b minus 3e, and q to the power e. So, in the power, there are only two constant, b and e. So, we group the parameter. So, eta equal to k multiplied by mu by rho omega d square to the power b, and q by omega d to the power 3 to the power e. Now, the relationship, eta is a function of mu by omega rho omega d square and q by omega d to the power 3. So, this is the expression from the expression of dimensionless eta in terms of the other parameter. So, eta efficiency is a function of mu by rho omega d square and q by d omega d to the power 3. Example number 2. Discharge Q through a small orifice of diameter D under a head of H depends upon the density rho of the liquid and its viscosity and acceleration due to gravity G. Obtain an expression for the discharge. So, this is from November 2009 question paper. So, here the discharge Q depends on the diameter D, head H, density rho, acceleration due to gravity G, and viscosity mu. So, Q is a function of capital D, capital H, rho, mu and G. So, in the Buckingham pi method, we are going to solve the problem by Buckingham pi method. For Buckingham pi method, we express a function of Q, D, H, rho, mu and G equal to 0. Now, among the variables, 6 variables available. So, number of variables available is 6. Number of repeating variable, we have to fix the number of repeating variables. So, for repeating variable, we have to identify one geometrical variable, one flow parameter, flow variable, another one is fluid property. So, there are three different types of property in the Buckingham pi method: geometrical property, fluid property and flow property. So, in the among the 6 variables available here, we have to take one geometrical property, one flow property and one fluid property. So, these are all the three properties required. But here, looking at the problem, there is no flow property. There is no flow property like velocity. Velocity is a flow property. Velocity is not available here. Any velocity is not available here. So, there is no flow property. So, we take only two properties. One is the fluid property. Another one is geometrical property. So, the number of repeating variable m equal to 2, then number of pi terms equal to n minus m. So, 6 minus 2 equal to 4. There are 4 pi terms. Now, the repeating variable. So, we take geometric property and the fluid property. So, there is no flow property. We take only geometric property and the fluid property. Among the geometric property, so d and h, we take d is the repeating variable. Among the flow property like rho and mu, we take rho is the fluid property. Now, we take the write the pi terms. So, pi 1 equal to the repeating variable to the power coefficient and one non-repeating variable. So, there are 4 pi terms, pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 and pi 4. So, pi 1 equal to d to the power a 1, rho to the power b 1 and one non-repeating variable q. Pi 2 equal to d to the power a 2, rho to the power b 2 and h. Pi 3 equal to d to the power a 3, rho to the power b 3 and mu. Pi 4 equal to d to the power a 4, rho to the power b 4 and g. So, q, h, mu and g, they are the non-repeating variable. D and rho are the repeating variables. The repeating variables will be available in all the pi terms and each pi term is represented in terms of the non-repeating variable. Now, we have to find the coefficients. A1, B1, A2, B2, A3, B3, A4, B4, everything we have to calculate and we have to write the pi terms and we have to write the functional relationship. Now, the dimensions of various parameters involved in the problem. So, discharge Q equal to unit is m meter cube per second and dimensions is L to the power 3, T to the power minus 1. Diameter D, unit is meter, dimension is L. H head h unit is meter, dimension is l. Mu viscosity ns by meter square, l m l to the power minus 1 t to the power minus 1. Density rho kilogram per meter cube, m l to the power minus 3. Acceleration due to gravity g, m meter per second square, l t to the power minus 2. Now substituting the dimensions in the pi term. So pi 1 term. So pi 1 equal to d to the power a1 rho to the power b1 into q. So left hand side is non-dimensional. Pi 1 is an pi terms are non-dimensional. So m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0, and l to the power a1, m l to the power minus 3 b1, l to the power 3, t to the power minus 1. So discharge unit is l to the power 3, t to the power minus 1. Now comparing the power of MLT on both sides. For M, there is no left hand side always 0. Right hand side we have only one M term B1. So B1 equal to 0. For L, 0 equal to A1 minus 3 B1 plus 3. So this equal from here A1 equal to minus 3 because B1 equal to 0, A1 equal to minus 3. So for T, left hand side 0, right hand side minus 1. There is no other value. So there is no T term. Now here by comparing the coefficient, we identify C1 equal to 0, B1 equal to 0, A1 equal to minus 3. Now substituting in the pi term. So pi1 equal to D1 to the power A1, rho 1, rho to the power B1 and the Q. So A1 equal to minus 3. So D to the power minus 3, rho to the power 0 into Q. Into Q. So this we can write as Q divided by D to the power 3. So the pi1 term equal to Q divided by D to the power 3. Then pi 2 term. So pi 2 equal to d to the power a 2 b to the power rho to the power b 2 into h. So in terms of dimensions, m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0 for pi 2. So l to the power a 2, m l to the power minus 3 to the power b 2. For h the dimension is l. Now once again comparing the powers of MLT. ML, this only M and there is no T term, M and L on both sides. For M, so 0 equal to B2, so B2 equal to 0. For L, 0 equal to A2 minus 3B2 plus 1. So A2 equal to minus 1. So B2 becomes 0, A2 equal to minus 1. Now pi 2 equal to, so pi 2 equal to, you substitute here, D to the power A2, rho to the power B2 into H. So a2 equal to minus 1, b2 equal to 0. So d to the power minus 1, rho to the power 0 into h. So this may be h by d. So pi 2 equal to h by t. Then pi 3 term. So pi 3 equal to d to the power a3, rho to the power b3 into mu. So in the left hand side, m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0. And we here we have l to the power a3 for rho m l to the power minus 3, b to the power b3. And m l the dimension of mu m l to the power minus 1 t to the power minus 1. Now comparing the powers of MLT on both sides. So m 0 equal to b3 plus 1. So b3 equal to minus 1. So the t term is not there. So t term we have, but left hand side there is no coefficient. So t equal to minus 1. So 0 equal to minus 1. So c there is no c term. Now second L equal to 0 left hand side. So on the right hand side A3 minus B3, 3B3 minus 1. So A3 equal to 1 plus 3B3, which is 1 minus 3 equal to minus 2. So the coefficient A3 equal to minus 2, B3 equal to minus 1. So substituting pi 3 equal to D to the power A3, rho to the power B3 into mu. So substituting A3 equal to minus 2. So D to the power minus 2, rho to the power minus 1 into mu. So rearranging mu divided by rho d square. So pi 3 equal to mu divided by rho d square. Then pi 4. So pi 4 term. So pi 4 equal to d to the power a 4 rho to the power b 4 into g. So writing the dimensions, left hand side m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0. Right hand side l to the power a 4, m l to the power minus 3 to the power b 4. And for g it is l t to the power minus 2. Now comparing the powers of MLT on both sides. So M B4 equal to 0 and there is no T term. So T 0 equal to minus 2. So for L we write 0 on the left hand side A4 minus 3 B4 plus 1. So A4 equal to minus 1. So the pi 4 term, so pi 4 equal to d to the power a 4 rho to the power b 4 into g, which is d to the power minus 1 rho to the power 0 into g. So we can write as g by d. So pi 4 equal to g by d. So we have calculated all the pi terms, pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 and pi 4. Now we write the equation. We can combine. So we can combine pi 2 and pi 3 terms, pi 3 and pi 2 and pi 4 terms, and we call it as pi 5. So it is square root of pi 2 into pi 4 equal to square root of h by d into g by d, which is square root of gh by d square equal to square root of gh divided by d. Now the functional relationship, so pi 1 equal to phi into pi 3 minus pi 3 and pi 3 comma pi 5. So q by d cube equal to a function of mu by rho d square comma square root of gh divided by d. So q is equal to d to the power 3 into a function of mu by rho d square comma square root of gh by d. So this is the functional relationship between discharge and other dimension, other parameter, other variable in the problem. So we take the example number 3. The pressure difference delta p in a pipe of diameter d and the length l due to turbulent flow depends on the velocity v, viscosity mu, density rho and roughness k. Using the Buckingham's pi theorem, obtain expression for delta p. So this question was appeared in November 2009 and May 2010. So the solution for the problem, the pressure difference in the pipe delta p depends on diameter d, length l, velocity v, viscosity mu, density rho and roughness k. So the expression delta p is a function of all the other variables d, l, v, mu, rho and k. So for the Buckingham pi method, we write f a function of all the variables, a function of delta p, diameter, length, velocity, viscosity, density and roughness factor is equal to 0. Now the number of variables in the problem, they are 7. We identify 3 repeating variables, one geometrical property, one fluid property and one flow property. So 3 repeating variables, then number of pi terms n minus m, so 7 minus 3 equal to 4. So the repeating variables, geometric property I take d, among d and l we take d, flow property we take velocity v and the fluid property we take rho density, other than mu and rho we take the density rho. So the repeating variables are d, v and rho, all the other variables are non repeating variables. So the non repeating variables are delta p, l, mu and k. So these are all the non-repeating variables. Now we write the pi terms. So there are 4 pi terms. In all the 4 pi terms, there will be the repeating variable will be available. So d, v, rho will be available in all the pi terms and one non-repeating variable available in the each pi term. Now the 4 pi terms are pi 1 equal to d to the power a 1, b to the power b 1, rho to the power c 1 into delta p. Pi 2 equal to d to the power a 2, b to the power b 2, rho to the power c 2 into mu. Pi 3 equal to d to the power a 3, v to the power b 3, rho to the power c 3 into l. Pi 4 equal to d to the power a 4, v to the power b 4, rho to the power c 4 into k. Now, the way dimensions of various parameters involved in the problem. So, pressure difference delta p in newtons per meter square, the unit is m l to the power minus 1, t to the power minus 2. Diameter d, the unit is meter, dimension is l. Length l, the unit is meter, dimension is l. Velocity v meters per second, unit is l t to the power minus 1, density rho kilogram per meter cube is the unit, m l to the power minus 3, viscosity mu newton second by meter square, so m l to the power minus 1 t to the power minus 1, roughness factor m, unit is meter is the unit and dimension is l, roughness is measured in terms of meter. Now, substituting the dimension terms, we have to find out each pi term. So, for pi 1 term, so pi 1 equal to d to the power a 1, v to the power b 1, rho to the power c 1 into delta p. Now, we substitute the dimension of all the term. So, for pi term, m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0. So, for d, l to the power a 1, l t to the power minus 1, b 1 to the power b 1, m l to the power minus 3 to the power c1, and delta p, the unit is m l to the power minus 1 t to the power minus 2. Now, the comparing the powers of m l t on both sides. So, for m, we will get 0 equal to c1 plus 1. So, c1 equal to minus 1. For l, 0 equal to a1 plus b1 minus 3c1 plus 1. And for t, 0 equal to minus b1 plus 2. So, from here, third term, b1 equal to minus 2. So, substituting here, a1 equal to 3c1 plus 1 minus b1 equal to minus 3 plus 1 plus 2 equal to 0. So, a1 becomes 0, b1 becomes 2 minus 2 and c1 becomes minus 1. Now, substituting here, so d to the power a1, b to the power b1, rho to the power c1 into delta p. So, substituting a1 equal to 0, d to the power 0, b to the power minus 2, rho to the power minus 1 into delta p. So, delta p, phi 1 equal to delta p divided by rho v square. Then pi 2 term. So, pi 2 equal to d a to the power 2, v to the power b2, rho to the power c2 into mu. Substituting dimensions, m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0, that is equal to l to the power a2, l t1 to the power b2, m l to the power minus 3 whole to the power c2, and the dimension of mu equal to m l to the power minus 1, t to the power minus 1. Now, comparing the coefficients of m l t on both sides, so we will get 0 for m, 0 equal to t c2 plus 1, so c2 equal to minus 1. So, for l equal to, we take t equal, for t 0 equal to minus b2 minus 1, so b2 equal to minus 1. For t l equal to 0 equal to a2 plus b2 minus 3c1 equal to 3c1 minus 1, so a2 equal to 3c2 plus 1 minus b2, substituting minus 3 plus 1 equal to minus 1. So, here a2 equal to minus 1, b2 equal to minus 1, c2 equal to minus 1, and substituting in the pi 2 terms. So, pi 2 equal to d to the power a2, b to the power b2, rho to the power c2 into mu. So, a2, b2, c2, they are minus 1. So, pi 2 equal to d to the power minus 1, b to the power minus 1, rho to the power minus 1 into mu. So, pi 2 equal to mu by rho dv. So, this is the second term, pi 2 term. Then, pi 3 term. So, pi 3 equal to d to the power a3, b to the power b3, rho to the power c3 into l. So, substituting the dimensions, m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0, that is equal to l to the power a3, l t to the power minus 1 to the power b3, m l to the power minus 3 to the power c3 and l. And comparing the powers of mlt on both sides, for m, 0 equal to c3, so c3 equal to 0. For t, 0 equal to minus b3, so b3 equal to 0. So, for l, 0 equal to a3 plus b3 minus 3c3 plus 1. So, solving this equation, a3 equal to minus 1. So, a3 equal to minus 1, b3, c3, they are 0. Now, the pi 3 term, d to the power a3, v to the power b3, rho to the power c3 into l. So, here pi 3 equal to d to the power minus 1, v to the power 0, rho to the power 0 into l. So, pi 3 equal to l by d. Then, pi 4 term. So, pi 4 equal to d to the power a4, v to the power b4, rho to the power c4 into k. So, substituting the dimensions, m to the power 0, l to the power 0, t to the power 0 equal to l to the power a4, l t to the power minus 1 to the power b4, m l to the power minus 3 to the power c4 into l. So, comparing the powers of mlt on both sides. So, for m, 0 equal to c4. So, 0 equal, c4 equal to 0. For t, 0 equal to minus b4. So, b4 equal to 0. For l, 0 equal to a4 plus b4 minus 3c4 plus 1. So, a4 equal to minus 1. So, substituting in the pi term. So, pi 4 equal to d to the power a4, b to the power b4, rho to the power c4 into k. So, pi 4 equal to d to the power minus 1, b to the power 0, rho to the power 0 into k. So, pi 4 equal to k by d. Now, we calculated all the pi terms, pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 and pi 4 terms. Now, we write the functional relationship. So, the functional relationship phi 1 equal to a function of phi, phi is a function of phi 2, phi 3 and phi 4. So, substituting phi 1, phi 2, phi 3, delta p by rho v square equal to a function of phi of mu by rho dv, comma l by d, comma k by d. Now, delta p is equal to rho v square into a function of mu by rho v dv L by D and K by D. So this is the functional relationship between delta P and other variables in the problem. So we stop here. We will continue with the problem solving in the next lecture. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find the book Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. You refer to the book for additional problems in the dimensional analysis and the theory part of the dimensional analysis. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again with additional problems in the dimensional analysis in the next lecture.